friends, hope you all are doing well. This is actually done to mainly focus on an important topic, that is a fiber to fabric, which is the third chapter in your science syllabus. So let's start the discussion. The chapter name is fiber to fabric. So let's start. First, the question arises, what is fiber? Fiber is a long, thin strand or thread of material. It is the smallest visible unit of any textile product. They are flexible and may be spun into yarn and made into fabrics. So next the question arises, what is fabrics? Fabrics are made of fibers. It is a cloth material. It is made by weaving or knitting threads together. Knitting means it is a method by which yarn is manipulated to create a textile or fabric. Now let's talk about the classification of fibers. Fibers, they are mainly classified into two types. First is natural and another is man-made. Natural fibers means the fibers that are produced by plants, animals and geological processes. So, under the section of natural fibers comes plants, animal and mineral. Fibers that come from plants include cotton, linen, kapok, jute and hemp. Among these, cotton is important for you to know right now. Next, talking about the animal sources, you get silk and wool, which are also very important. And under the mineral falls asbestos, though it's not mentioned in your book, so you can easily skip it. Talking about the man-made sources, the type of fibers that is made artificially are known as man-made fibers. And under these fibers, we get polyester, acrylic, rayon and nylon. That you can see in the slide. Well, try to remember this entire T diagram as it is very important and it will help you to proceed the chapter. Next is the processing of silk. We obtain silk from silkworm and wool from sheep. That brings us to the next slide, that is silk. In this particular section, we will be dealing how silk is obtained and the entire steps involved in it. So let us learn about the processing of silk. At first, moth, they lays eggs. Then, that eggs hatch giving silkworms or larva. Next, silkworm eat mulberry leaves and grow in size. During this phase, they shed their skin 4 times. Shedding of skin is called molding. Well, 4 times is not very important to remember, so you can skip it if you want. Next, silkworms begin spinning their cocoons, which means they start making cocoons around themselves. The silk that is used in forming these cocoons is actually hardened silkworm saliva that has been secreted from the silkworm's mouth. There is actually a small spinneret that is located on the silkworm's lip, which is used to excrete the silk that they use to form their cocoon. Next, silk farmers collect these cocoons and filaments are obtained from cocoons by the process called reeling. Silk fibers are then spun into silk threads. With the help of a spinning yarn, you can spin the fibers into threads and that is how you get the silk thread. So, over here, this is given the role of different components, different roles of people that are involved in making of the silk. The entire process is explained here, so let us see step by step. Well, hope this is clear to you. I guess it's visible. So let's start. First is about the silk farmers. What they do? They pair up the male and female moths, they mate and then they lay eggs. These eggs then hatch into larva. And larva can also be known as silkworms. So the next question arises, what do this larva feed on? They feed on mulberry leaves, and this mulberry leaves or plants are supplied by the agricultural farmers, and they supply the mulberry saplings to the silk farmers. After feeding on the mulberry leaves, they make a cocoon around themselves. And over what happens? Molting, that is shedding of skin. Then they spin the silk and make the cocoon. Cocoon is then used by reelers. As you can see, then it is used by the reelers. Reelers means the one who obtain the filament or fibers. That is the process of reeling. And how it is done? Cocoons are boiled by farmers to obtain the thread. And then these fibers are spun by the process of spinning into silk threads. These are then, as you can see, the next part. These are then twisted and dyed. Dyed means coloring. And finally, you get the weaving, which is done by the weavers. What do these weavers do? They make it into fabric. I hope this entire process is quite clear to you. Means at first, the silk farmers, they pair up the male and female moths. Then they hatch the eggs, and the silkworms, they feed on the mulberry leaves, which are then provided by the farmers, as you can see. Next, the silkworms spin silk. Then, slowly, they start forming the cocoon around themselves. Then, reeling occurs, which is done by the reelers. Then, it is being twisted. Dyed means colored, as you can get the fabrics in different colors. And after that, weaving is done. That is, weaving of the silk fabric. Silk fiber is obtained from the cocoon of the silk moth. As you know, the breeding and management of silkworms for the production of silk is called sericulture. Try to remember this term. Next comes the difference between natural silk and artificial silk. Natural silk, it is an animal fiber that is made up of protein, and it is obtained from the cocoons of silkworms. For example, mulberry silk. Whereas artificial silk, they are made of cellulose. And it is obtained from the wood pulp, and as you can get the artificial silk, that is rayon, nylon, etc. Next, coming to another important topic, that is wool, which is another animal fiber. To obtain wool, sheep are reared. And how it happens? Let's see. At first comes the selective breeding. It is the process which involves choosing parents with particular characteristics to breed together and produce offspring with more desirable characteristics. To obtain wool, sheep are at first reared, and it happens by the following processes. At first, the sheep are sheared to remove the fleece. Well, the fleece is not the wool, it is only the hair. And fleece is the cut off wool coat of a sheep along with a thin layer of skin. It is covered by an oily substance called yoke, which consists of wool grease and dry perspiration. It protects the sheep from becoming matted. The fleece of a sheep consists of two types of fiber that forms its fleece. First, the coarse beard hair, and second, the fine and soft under hair, means the hair that grows very close to the skin. And these under hairs are used for making the wool. Processing of fibers into wool involves the following steps. First, the fleece of the sheep along with a thin layer of skin is removed by machines, and this process is called shearing. Well, when it is removed by machines, at that time, do remember one thing, that shearing does not hurt the sheep, as the uppermost layer of the skin of the sheep is dead. Next, The sheared hair is thoroughly washed in tanks to remove grease, dust and dirt. And this process is called scouring. Clean hair skin is then sent to the factory where hair of different textures are sorted. Sorted means separated. And this process is called sorting. The small fluffy fibers called burrs are picked out from this hair. The natural fleece of sheep and goats is black, white or brown, as you can see. So these fibers are dyed in various colors. The fibers are then straightened, combed and rolled into yarn. The shorter fibers are spun and woven into woolen cloth, and the longer fibers are made into wool for sweaters. These are some important topics about the chapter, that is, fibers obtained from animals are called animal fibers, that includes wool and silk. Wool is obtained from the fleece, that is hairy growth of animals such as goat, sheep, alpaca, etc. Next, the wool yielding animals have a thick coat of hair which traps a lot of air. And as you all know that air is a very poor conductor of heat. So hairs keep these animals warm by shielding their body from cold during winter. And due to this reason, hairs of these animals are removed only once in a year at the beginning of summer season. Then the hair grows again by the time when winter arrives and protects them. Next comes the different breeds of sheep. It is given in your page 33. You can read it if you want, otherwise you can skip it, but just have a look. Next comes the shorter stitches. People, those who are working in the wool industry, they are sometimes get infected by a bacteria which is known as anthrax. Actually, it leads to a fatal blood disease which is known as the sorter's disease. Well, I guess the chapter is quite clear to you. I have just focused only on the important topics related to the chapter. Hope it will be helpful for you. So, here I end my slide presentation. Hope you all do well. Thank you.